chapter. We are on a roller coaster and we are going places. You will all agree that we are going places. One of the things that we did some time back, that was in May to be precise, we organized an international conference, and that is where you all made your presentations. And after the seminar was over, after the conference was over, it was suggested, why don't you bring the books out together? Why don't you bring the papers out in a book form? And we ho-hummed, and then we finally said, why not? So we got round to it and we did it. So we are here because the work has now, it's come to a conclusion, as you know, and we are here to celebrate. We are here for a formal launch. So welcome to this session, everyone. I've given you the background, and I must introduce you to department out here, the two faculty members who have brought this baby into the world. So we have Dr. Purnima Bali. Purnima, where are you, Purnima?
I'm here, right here, ma'am. So, thank you so much.
So that is Purnima Bali, and she is one of my young colleagues who has been responsible for editing the book. Purnima, why don't you say something? We will be going on to the best, which will come a little later. That is the Vice Chancellor, but first Purnima will explain. Yeah, Purnima?
Okay, so should I go for exact introduction about me or something? So today is truly an honor for me to express what I'm feeling right now, right? This literary journey has been extremely exciting and intriguing, which is definitely going to lift up the writing part in all of us, right? So this publication has opened up and raised the horizon and the zenith of our literary side. When we talk about writing and research, one face that comes to our mind is none other than our Vice Chancellor, sir. Sir, you are an inspiration to all of us. And why so? Because you're always there to skill ourselves for something which seems impossible for us. Thank you so much, sir, for being there always. Another name that is Atul, sir, who is our pro-vice chancellor and dean also, and is the driving force behind whatever we are aspiring for. His vision and thinking out of the box attitude keeps us going. Sir, please accept our heartfelt gratitude. When we entered the faculty space today in the morning, whole FMSLA family was so excited, and that's why we call this family, this team, our extended family. Thank you so much, everyone. And when we first saw the cover page of the book, there was one person who was happier than us, who did all the hard work, pushed us to do all the best dress part, kept herself behind the curtain, made us the stars today, such a selfless leader. She is silently smiling right now and pretending as if she has not done anything in this publication. Professor Manju Jaidka, ma'am, no words for your being.
Okay, enough.
Okay. So now, believe me, this is just the beginning. And ma'am is sometimes getting up at 3 in the morning with the new ideas, and we start working on that. So in the morning, she dropped a text to me, which I'm going to share with you. And that is, she said, khudi ko kar buland itna ki har takdeer banane se pehle khuda bande se puche bata teri raza kya hai. Thank you so much, ma'am, and thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you, Purnima. And as she said, you know, this is just the beginning. These are baby steps that we are taking. When I joined the university, it was 8 months ago. When I joined the university, I was told that this is a fledgling department and you'll have to make something out of it. Well, I'm trying to make something out of it, and I'm a bit of a danda master. I like being a danda master, and these kids listen to me. Huh? So, they are behaving, and if not, I'm a danda master, remember. So these are baby steps, these are first steps, and the first steps are the most difficult. Now, the other co-editor is Neeraj. Neeraj, where are you? Neeraj Pizar. I always have a problem remembering his name. Hello. Because I remember lots of delectable things like pizzas and so on. So Neeraj is here. Neeraj, what do you have to say?
Hello. Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, all of you. So I don't have much to say, but first of all, I would like to thank our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Khosla, and our Pro-Vice Chancellor, Professor Atul Khosla, for providing us this opportunity and believing in our department. So coming to the book, the journey for getting this book published, it began in the month of May after the conference that we had here in the Shoolini University. So after the conference, I was assigned conference papers by Professor Jaidka, and I was asked to edit those papers. First, I was asked to read those papers, and then I was asked to edit those papers, and lastly, I was asked to write the paper regarding George Orwell's dystopic.
Anything is achievable. Everybody gets the opportunities. Best people are those who can take advantage of that opportunity and convert it into success. Even Poonam has also done some help to me. In my acknowledgments, I'm putting her name also. Well, by then, when Poonam asked Poonam to do it, Ashish and his wife, both of my husband and daughter-in-law, they agreed, they did it. Now the book is in the rough form, rough proofing, and now final, all those things are going on. After each chapter, I've given my learning. I always thought, why should anybody read my book? The publisher said, no, people will read. Because you are an average man, average family, average academic art to begin with, and you are converted. I have been suspended twice in the university. Even as a vice chancellor, I was suspended. God gave, the court gave strictures against me in some admission case. I will call it all the luck, but I changed that adversity into opportunity. Because I got the chance to meet the chief minister, because I had to protect myself. I showed those 15 books. You see, my effort done as an editor, so there is a correlation. When I put the 15 books on the table of the chief minister, sir, what is this? I said, sir, a person who has edited 15 books in his life, he cannot be nalak. I cannot be poor. I cannot be weak. People may talk anything. That minute I stole the show. And everything, the whole thing, sir, changed. The chief minister ultimately finally said, okay, Dr. Khosla, I will support you. Let the court decide. We cannot intervene in the judicial matter. Let the court decide. So not only things ended here, after my tenure as vice chancellor, he offered me the post of the scientific advisor to the state government. So it became, if I had not been suspended, I would not have got the chance to meet the chief minister. I've been an ordinary person. Dr. Khosla has come as a vice chancellor. His term is over, he goes back. But special reason made me. And then something else was to come. I entered into the seat of the power in the secretariat. Oh, then the idea of private education came to me. And then I was 64, 65 years of age. I left that job, entered into private education, and Shoolini University is today here. And it is a research centric university. And now we are developing liberal arts also. Manju is taking the lead. I'm very happy. I grade her one of the best persons in the university because she's from Punjab University. And I also similar traits that you should create your own position, your own place in the scenario, and nothing succeeds like success. So wish you all the best, Neeraj and Poonam. God bless you. I wish everybody and welcome everyone a good opportunity to release the book, or to be one of the two bitterness of book being released of the young author. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. So you know where we get our inspiration from. It all comes from the head of the family, the head of the Shoolini family, that is Professor Khosla. Thank you, sir. We are trying to follow in your footsteps. And as you said, as William Blake once said famously, I must create my own universe or else be enslaved by another man's. I must create my own universe or else be enslaved by another man's. That is what you have done. And that is what we all try to do. So thank you very much. As you know, this is an e-publication. It's an e-publication. It's been published on Kindle and Amazon. It has an ISBN number, and the essays have been peer reviewed. You will not find any editorial typos or errors, as far as, you know, we've tried to take care of it. And besides, those of you who have published here, you need not be afraid of copyrights. Nobody is going to challenge you if you want to publish the same essay somewhere else. But in your own interest, it is best to cite that this essay, that your essay was once published, was earlier published in this Kindle publication. Why? Because it's all online. And if you publish this paper somewhere else and somebody gets to know, hey, this was published in another place, so it'll be awkward for you. So you're most welcome to publish wherever you want, but please acknowledge that it was first published in this e-Kindle book. And e-publication is not as difficult as you might think, because now everything is online, everything is virtual, but the standards have to be maintained because it is everybody's access. You can buy the Kindle book, and if you have Kindle Unlimited, then you can actually download it for free. So it's a great way to reach out. And then if we are about 30 of us associated with the book, and if 30 of us have, say, 100 friends who can download it and read it, you can see how far it will go. And then, of course, the sense of responsibility is also there. There has to be something solid, something worthwhile in what you are circulating. Anyway, that is about the book now. I'm going to introduce all the speakers one by one, but before that, I would like to mention that apart from the Vice Chancellor, our dear Vice Chancellor, we have a lot of important senior members of the university and the trustees out here. I cannot see Professor Atul Khosla. Atul, sir, are you here? Atul, sir, are you here?
Atul is not here today.
Right.
He's in Shimla. Okay. There's an urgent meeting.
And Avni, ma'am, are you here? Avni, are you here? Avni? Ashish, sir? Ashu, ma'am?
Ashu, ma'am, is here.
Hi, Ashu. I must tell you that Ashu is also a writer. And, you know, she's amazing. She's got her fingers in so many pies. I mean, she's into medicine. She's an expert in this, that, into artificial intelligence, into literature. And I feel very inadequate when I talk to her. But she's a lovely person. This is Ashu. And Saroj, ma'am, we wanted Saroj, ma'am, also to be here. Is Saroj, ma'am, here? Saroj, ma'am, is First Lady of the University. What about Nishtha? Nishtha, ma'am, are you here? Nishtha Shukla? Vishal? Vishal Anand? Shikha?
We'll be there, Shimla.
Shikha, are you here? Shikha? No. All right. So these are trustees and all their good wishes are here with us. But let me now come to the contributors. And each contributor will take a couple of sentences to talk about, to introduce himself or herself, and and mention their role in the making of the book. I am going to start with the two academicians who gave their comments on the book and as the blurb, and that is also there in the final edition. May I ask Manpreet? Manpreet, are you here? Yes, Manpreet. So we are going more or less in the order in which the essays are published. Manpreet, would you like to introduce yourself and say a few words?
Right. Good morning, everybody. I'm Manpreet Kang, and currently I'm the dean and I'm a professor at School of Humanities and Social Sciences, Guru Gobind Singh, Indraprastha University, Delhi. I would also like to mention that I've been Professor Jaidka's scholar right from my master's, MPhil, and my PhD, and ever since. And I can see, her influence now on the younger faculty here. And Neeraj, when you say that you were not really ever felt pressurized, I would disagree that maybe you will feel that later, but all to, I think your long-term growth. So, ma'am, I'll speak about some things later, but I think first of all, I would like to wish everybody good morning to the Vice Chancellor, Professor Khosla, who I had the opportunity of hearing when I attended one national seminar at the university, Shoolini University. And I would like to congratulate the university and the department for, amazingly being so active. I mean, before you know there's something else happening, there are two, three things already, we have a weekly talk and... So I think this is Professor Jaidka's energy and enthusiasm that I see, which will probably help the department grow. And I can relate to it totally because a lot of my motivation came from her. So I'm very happy to see that, again, very quickly, the seminar has now been converted into this book, The 20th Century, Literary Signposts and Watersheds. and edited by Purnima Bali, Neeraj Pizar. I congratulate both of you and, of course, like I said, the entire department. I have already mentioned in the book, I think it's a book which is quite comprehensive in terms that it has something for everybody, for young scholars, you know, some kind of simply written essays, but coverage very widely given to the entire 20th century, very relevant. And also we have comments from experts. So it will be useful for everybody. And so with this, again, I mean, you know, and I was associated with it because I was one of the chairs in one of the sessions, but that's my only contribution. But otherwise, I think it's an excellent book. And again, very typically, ma'am, brought out so fast, you know, otherwise, normally we don't get a book so quickly after a conference. So I think that's all I would like to say. But and a big congratulations to everybody, to all the contributors, to the editors, to the department, and to Shoolini University. Thank you for having me here today.
Thank you, Manpreet. Thank you so much. We go on to the next expert who gave us his opinion on the book, Deepankar. Deepankar, are you there? Deepankar? Hi, Deepankar. Yes, Deepankar, you are muted. Please unmute yourself. Please introduce yourself.
Good morning, everybody. I am Deepankar Pugaster. I am a retired professor of English from Assam University, Silchar.
Louder, please. Louder.
I take this opportunity of thanking the authorities of Shoolini University and particularly the Department of English and especially Professor Manju Jaidka for giving me this opportunity of associating with this project. Now, I find the project very interesting, and the way this whole idea of going back to basics, to the basic texts of English literature, something which we have almost forgotten in this mad rush for doing theory. Now, as I was reading the book, I was reminded of something which we had in our undergraduate days, something very important, and that is the Pelican Guide to English Literature, which was very useful in those days. And I hope this particular publication will be equally useful for young teachers and students at the, as a sort of a opportunity to know an area in its totality. And now may I share with Professor Jaidka and the Department of English an idea which came to my mind as I was just listening to the deliberations here. Why not Shoolini organize seminars where they take up, just like the Pelican Guide, say next Victorian age, Romantic age, then from Dryden to Johnson, and finally going back to the medieval age? That would be a very useful contribution to the young university and college teachers and students. I thank everyone once again for giving me this opportunity of being here. Thank you.
Thank you, Deepankar. We are working towards it. Thank you so much.
Right.
Is Neelima here? Neelima? Neelima was one of the chairs in a session. Neelima Kanwar? I think I did see her. Neelima? Well, we'll come back to her. Nasser? Nasser is from Iran. Nasser, can you hear me? I got a message from him saying that he could not hear us. Nasser? Now, Nasser is here, but I think his audio and video is not working. He is in Tabriz in Iran. And he has also given a little write-up for the book. So Nasser is here. You can see him in the blue shirt. Nasser, if you can hear us, please speak up. No. All right, Mukesh Williams. Mukesh Williams is from Japan. Mukesh, please unmute yourself. Mukesh Williams, he's from Japan, Fusoka University, Japan. And I must tell you that we have a good, fairly good interaction with the Soka University because Mukesh is a very dynamic person. He's forever organizing something or the other. And he's inviting our students, and he has something else in the pipeline for which we will probably be giving a panel. So Mukesh Williams is here, and Mukesh gave the keynote for the seminar that we had organized. Mukesh, please introduce yourself and talk and say a few words.
Professor Jaidka, thank you very much for introducing me. Professor Khosla, our Vice Chancellor, thank you very much for this wonderful opportunity. And that without you, I don't think anybody could do anything. Your encouragement is profound, is very important. And we all cherish, all of us who have published and written in this small Kindle book, the 20th century. We thank you very much. So having said that, we write and we publish to leave our ideas in the receptacle of immortality. We want to be immortal. So we are very gregarious people and we want to celebrate our discoveries with other like-minded people. So the Kindle book we have launched today is called the 20th century. And it is the most important century. Whatever we see today is because of the 20th century. So when you read it again, the different essays, I'm sure you would be convinced by this argument that the 20th century has been, the impact of the 20th century has been profound. So the one important thing I want to talk about today is the tightening of language which the 20th century gave to us. To speak with exactness and to enter history through language. Then enter the past through language. So language is a very important key, and Kindle has given us this kind of digital immortality. How the 20th century was shaking up everything that was created before, the Victorians created a very structured world of intellectual self-assurance. So I don't want to go into all that. You can please read it. But on this occasion, I wish to thank each one of you who spoke at the conference and who sent your papers for publication. So all this requires a lot of effort. And I wish to thank my dear friend, Professor Manju Jaidka, so who executes all her ideas and helps others to do so. So this is something I want to learn, and I wish I can follow what she is doing. I also want to heartily thank the editors, Purnima, Bali, and Neeraj, Pizar from Shoolini University. So you are young and you have the passion and the fire, which is very important. Nothing gets burnt without fire. So passion is fire. And that is very important. We have retired. We are on a different level. You can take our help, but you have to move, and you have moved. So the editing of the book, you know how, to bring together all the conference papers. And since it is on Kindle Amazon, we can read with pleasure without going anywhere. So thank you very much for launching this book. And I wish to thank everyone that without you, it would not be possible. And especially
thank you,
Vice Chancellor Professor Khosla. Thank you very much.
And Mukesh is doing a lot of work too. And there are lots of other plans in the pipeline. We'll be collaborating on that very soon. Sanjay Mukherjee, is Sanjay Mukherjee here? I think I did see him. Sanjay, yes, Sanjay Mukherjee, please introduce yourself and briefly tell us about your role in the book. Yeah.
Good morning, esteemed Professor Khosla, Professor Jaidka, distinguished panel, including the keynote speaker, Professor Williams. This was one of the earliest systematic webinars during the lockdown period. And the graph of this webinar today, as it concludes with the publication, e-publication, is this logical trajectory that is so interesting and so inspiring. Including small things, like when this webinar was announced, Professor Jaidka sent out a mail as a kind of a hand-holding mail to distinguish between reading a paper in a conference and looking at the camera and speaking up. Now, these are minor things, but for us, oldish 50 plus people, we are used to generally looking down and reading a paper. These are very important things, and this is a turning point in academic events. From seminars, we are moving to webinars. And from hard copy publication, as Professor Williams rightly mentioned, we are moving into e-publications. Incidentally, I have got the Kindle purchased yesterday and downloaded, and I have a copy. To all the students, my research scholars, my colleagues, whomsoever I mentioned the title of this webinar, mentioning the signposts and watersheds, everybody liked it so much. And they said, these are wonderful. This is a wonderful title also. So everything I think has been right. And I congratulate Team Shoolini, including right from Professor Khosla to Professor Jaidka and the two young editors. We have high hopes from you, Professor Bali and Dr. Neeraj Pizar. My little role was a paper on the wasteland. And I was very apprehensive. I thought that this is such a big literary signpost that many papers would come. And I was apprehensive. I thought, should I? I even wrote a mail to Professor Jaidka saying that there are other signposts vis-a-vis Eliot, like tradition and the individual talent. And Professor Jaidka very beautifully turned the discussion back to the wasteland. I thought there would be so many papers. And incidentally, I could, within the word span given to me, only discuss the beginning of this great poem. And towards the end of my paper, connecting it to some of the post-70s theories, how Professor Williams was saying, and Professor Purkaista was saying, that how we have to go back to our texts. How texts, great texts, actually anticipate theories. And this little thing I attempted to do in my paper. I once again thank the entire Team Shoolini and for giving me this opportunity. It is really a great honor and pleasure to be part of this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sanjay. And I must tell you, this is the first time that I met Sanjay, and we liked his presentation so much that I called him back to be a discussant in a later session. So thank you very much, Sanjay. And I must tell you that we are organizing another seminar, another conference, the Mini Mellow Conference in October, 9th, 10th, and 11th October. The call has gone out, and it has also been advertised on conference alerts internationally on the UPenn website. And there's a small window when you can put in your abstract. So by the 5th of September, if I get your abstracts, fine, we will consider them. If they come later, we will not be able to. So all of you who are waiting, just pull up your socks and get cracking. Sudipta, are you here? Sudipta?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, yes, ma'am, I'm here.
Please introduce yourself. And
thank you, ma'am. Good morning, all of you. My name is Sudipta Shaha. I am a lecturer at the Department of English, Rendranath College, Kolkata. And first of all, I would like to say that I feel so thrilled, so excited to have this, just to see this book, this and my name in this publication. And first of all, I would like to thank the Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Khosla. And after Professor Khosla, it comes Professor Manju Jaidka, ma'am, whose tireless efforts.
Yeah, carry on, Sudipta. But
this book, Professor okay. Purnima Bali and Professor.
I think we are losing your voice in between.
My chapter is titled "Serious, Proper, and Wise: Philip Larkin and the Movement Poetry." where I have seen the movement poetry through the eyes of Philip Larkin, as he has provided everything in a straightforward and in a very colloquial language. And as Professor Purakaista has said, that this book will be a hands-on for the students of literature, for the UG students or the PG students, and also for young professors who are just starting their life in academics. Thank you so much. And thank you so much for this opportunity, Shoolini University, Department of English. Thank you so much, especially Manju Jaidka.
Thank you, Sudipta. So thank you, Sudipta. And we come to Ahmed. Ahmed, are you here? Ahmed is from Bangladesh. And you know, when we were having our seminar, what happened was there was that cyclonic storm that came, and his connection was disrupted. But still, we managed to read out his paper, and he did send in his paper later on, which is published in the collection. So we have Ahmed from Bangladesh out here. Ahmed, hi Ahmed.
Hello, this is Professor Ahmed Asanujaman. I am teaching at Independent University, Bangladesh, which is based in the capital city, Dhaka. I used to be teaching at Khulna University, and in fact, I am on loan from that university to serve this private university for 2 or 3 years. At Khulna University, I held the position of head of the department and also the dean of the Faculty of Arts. And here at Independent University, I am just trying to mentor my young colleagues and students, senior students. I would like to congratulate Professor Jaidka, of course, but then I must pay my tribute, humble tribute, to the Vice Chancellor of Shoolini University for his dynamic leadership. Professor Khosla, you are here, and a big thank to you. And the two young editors, Neeraj and Purnima, I haven't yet read the book, but I believe it's going to be a tremendous work. And as Professor Munja put it, it's a kind of a labor of love. And I believe that is going to be a wonderful, you know, profitable venture for all of us. So thank you, Professor Jaidka, for taking this initiative, taking this lead in this webinar world, because that was the first, as someone already put it, that was the first perhaps comprehensive webinar arranged. Systematic, of course, and it's tremendous that you could come up with the publication only in 2 months after the webinar. That's wonderful. It doesn't happen. It really doesn't happen. So I would like to congratulate all of you who worked tirelessly under the dynamic leadership of Professor Manju. My small role in this publication was that I considered once again a literary signpost of 20th century, and that was Beckett and Beckett's Waiting for Godot. But how a bilingual Bangladeshi writer, Bangladeshi playwright, Said Ahmed, who passed away some 6 years ago, took on Beckett from post-colonial perspective, that is, how Beckett's Waiting could be re-seen, revisited, reimagined, recontextualized in Bangladesh or in any part of the world, because it's the context which decides reception, is the context which, of course, you know, affects our understanding of a particular text. So that was my kind of take on Beckett. And once again, I would like to thank Shoolini University for organizing this webinar. And I would like to also thank all people at the Department of English and Faculty of Management who worked tirelessly to bring out this publication.
Thank you, Ahmed. That was really very nice, huh? Thank you. I was wondering, Nasser, have you come back? Nasser, is your speaker working now? Nasser from Iran, Tabriz? Nasser? Because he did raise a hand, so I thought maybe he has... come back on the audio. Nasser, we still cannot hear you. Anyway, we move on. And before I move on, may I make a request? You know, we have thanked people. We have thanked You have thanked me, you have thanked the Vice Chancellor. So instead of, you know, saying thank you, repeating the same thing, why don't you just introduce yourselves and tell us what your role in it. We take your thanks for granted. Thank you. Okay, Mahim, are you here? Mahim? Yes, Mahim.
Hi, I'm Mahim Sharma, and I have been a research scholar at IP University, and now I'm teaching at an affiliated college of IP University. I'm teaching English. And again, thank you all for this particular webinar, because I clearly remember I was extremely excited for this webinar because I loved the topic. I have always been driven. My entire PhD thesis was related to what all the cognitive changes happened in the 20th century and how it happened in science and in literature. So I was very excited. It all came back to me. And thank you for this opportunity. My role was that I contributed a paper that was related to Waiting for Godot and how the chaos involved in that paper in the text was reflective of the change of mind, of attitude. Like Virginia Woolf said that something in human nature had drastically changed around 1910. And that is something I personally cannot get over with, because it has been something revolutionary for all of us, especially when we are dealing with aesthetics and literature. And thank you again for working so hard on our paper, working for those commas and all those insight in-text mistakes that we must have done. So a lot of patience might have gone in that. So thank you once again for giving us this opportunity. And once again, Manju ma'am, I would like to give you a compliment, because whenever we interact with Manpreet ma'am, we have studied with Manpreet ma'am, she has had the same dynamic personality like you have. And I now find it from where she, adapted herself like that. So thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mahim. We go on to Disha. Disha, where are you? Hi, Disha, unmute yourself.
Yeah, good afternoon, ma'am.
Yeah.
And I'm very glad to be back. Exactly, I think right after 3 months, my presentation was, I believe, on the 29th of May, the first virtual conference of the lockdown. And it was a learning experience, because this idea of not reading and just looking at the camera and presenting was something that I wasn't used to before. And so it was quite an experience. And we are not supposed to thank, but I maybe just once I'll just say thank you, ma'am. And my contribution to the compilation is a paper on Albert Camus, The Outsider, and where I've tried to understand this idea of what it means to live in society, what it means to exist, and what are the dynamics of when we negotiate our identity with the society at large. What happens when we commit actions which are inevitably judged by others, and what kind of crisis that then eventually creates in a person's mind and soul. So that is how it's been, and I was very, very happy to be a part of that seminar and to be in the publication, which is the first book. Sometimes you don't know what the journey is going to turn into when you're taking the first step. And that's exactly how I feel since May. And today, which is the 28th of August. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Disha. Thank you. And we go on to Gaurav. Gaurav, are you here? Gaurav Mathur? Gaurav? Monali? Yes, Monali?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Good morning to one and all present here. And good morning, Professor Khosla, Professor Jaidka. I'm Monali Chatterjee from Nirma University, Ahmedabad, and I have had the privilege to contribute a paper, Chaos and Anarchy in Golding's Lord of the Flies, for this anthology. I highlighted the chaos, anarchy, and moral depravity in the Lord of the Flies that reverberates and pulsates in our lives at this time. The conference had been a potboiler for a host of fruitful deliberations. I congratulate Professor Manju Jaidka and her team and Shoolini University for this unique effort. And the kind of takeaways that I'm taking from this conference are immense, because it taught me to be precise, concise in both my written and oral presentations, feel like a TV presenter as I'm facing a camera now, and be ready to help and support the way Professor Jaidka has been doing and setting her an example. So thank you, Professor Purnima and Professor Neeraj, for editing the anthology. And thank you so much. And I wish you all the best for all the forthcoming efforts.
Thank you. Is Gaurav back? Gaurav? Rashmi? Rashmi Lee? Rashmi Lee George?
Yes. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm very happy to be part of this whole endeavor. In fact, I think it was probably one of the seminars that got me thinking that the lockdown period can really be very fruitful academically, you know, and something constructive such as an essay can come out of it. So I'm very thankful for this brainchild of Shoolini University, which has enabled all of us to participate and contribute. My contribution to this anthology was an essay called Lord of the Flies, an Eco-Critical Approach. And I love that novel, and I was very happy to take a new theoretical position while studying this particular text. And I'm very grateful that in such a short span of time, all these essays could be compiled and somebody could come out with a publication like this. So I'm very grateful, and I hope that it will be of use to everyone. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rashmi. That depends on you. You have to put it to good use. Yeah? Circulate it as much as you can. We come to Nilak. Nilak Datta, I saw you. Hi, Nilak. Unmute yourself, please. Unmute yourself. Nilak is all the way from Goa.
I hope I'm audible.
Yes, yes.
Well, good morning, everyone. I'm Nilak Datta from Pitspilani Goa campus. It's raining like cats and dogs now, so it's nothing fun at this point. But I'll definitely say that this seminar was, or this conference initially in the month of May was remarkable, because this is one of those conferences where I didn't fall asleep, because I'm usually notorious for, you know, 45 minutes and that's like boom, and then I start nodding and smiling, which means I'm really done. But this was one of those conferences where I stayed awake all the time. Throughout the entire, and I, you know, there was a lot that I really enjoyed listening to. And so I really think that this volume will make a big difference in terms of getting students to look back at the kind of texts that we usually tend to focus on, and not so much perhaps on theory. So I really loved it. In fact, I definitely want that we should have much more of these conferences and seminars, and we should bring out even more. And I think that this lockdown has been, whether we like it or not, been a blessing in disguise. I mean, for one thing, I'm beginning to feel like a TV presenter, and two, because I feel that bringing together a lot of these scholars and a lot of scholars from various backgrounds, and then be able to have a sort of common platform where we agree about various issues about texts, I think that is simply amazing. My own contribution was, I think, a small paper on George Orwell. And as I teach George Orwell in classes, how do I look at it? How do I look at doublethink as a post-industrial, post-truth kind of text, even though it was a modernist text and not a post-modernist one? That's sort of something that I dealt with. I won't go into the length into it, because you can always read it. But I was going through this material last night, and I was skim reading some of the essays. And it is simply amazing. It's an amazing experience. Sort of took me way back to the month of May when we were talking about all of these. So definitely, you know, I encourage this sort of effort, and I look forward to more of this. In fact, I'm looking forward to the mini mellow hangama, as it were.
Yeah, that we are having it on American literature this time. American literature. So thank you, Nilak. Thank you. And I must tell you, the point was raised some time back about us going back to the basics. B.O.B., back to our basics. We are going back to the basics because, frankly, we are living in times which are unprecedented. We are living in a time when the greatest reality, the terrible reality staring at us into our faces, is the pandemic, and we do not really know what to make of it. So instead of getting into theoretical jargon and talking about, you know, vague abstract things, it's better to focus on texts. It's better to focus on texts which show us different perspectives on life. That is what we are doing. Pratima, are you here? Pratima? I did see her some time back. Pratima? Well, if you're here,
please speak up.
Yeah, very nice. Where are you, Pratima?
Yeah, can you see me? Can you hear me?
We can hear you, but we can hear you. Pratima, briefly, please tell us about yourself and your contribution.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Pratima Agnihotri. I'm from Pune. And I'd like to say that both the webinar and the Kindle publication are very interesting for me for the simple reason that it shows us that literature, literary criticism, and technology can coexist happily together. Because I feel that, you know, the moment technology entered the literary world, that was supposed to be something which was almost threatening. But a webinar as well as the Kindle publication show us that they can happily coexist together. In my opinion, that time needs to be congratulated for that.
Thank you.
And my particular paper deals with the criticism. And my particular paper deals with 1984. And the combination of the
We are having problems with Pratima's mic. We are having problems with Pratima's audio. So Nasser, are you back? Nasser, can you hear us? I saw you raising your hand again. Well, never mind. Nikita?
Yes, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
All right. First of all, a very good morning to one and all. This was the first venture in which my research was going on to. And as soon as I got to know that I have this opportunity, and like Mahi mentioned, we are classmates, and Manpreet ma'am was the standpoint for us who introduced us to the entire idea of Mellow and how things are. But as far as this conference is concerned, it was amazing because it was the first initial point when I was in my research thinking about like how can I be more productive. And the point at which it happened, like ma'am already mentioned, like the pandemic was already there and we had no idea how to make it something positive out of it. So this came at the time when we ourselves do not know how to assemble ourselves. And I remember reading and picking, like my research is on the topic of madness. And I remember picking up my favorite book from bachelor's, which is Virginia Woolf's Mrs. Dalloway. And I read it again for the seminar and created another perspective from the point of view of Septimus Warren Smith. And that's how it is being done. And I will not dwell much into it because you guys can read it from the paper. But at the same time, I would like to thank everybody who has contributed, be it the editors, be it ma'am, everybody. And it's such a beautiful journey from which we began. Like we were just, if I call myself, I'm a naive person when it comes to the screen and everything. But ma'am made me comfortable. She made me realize even when the technical glitches were happening, she made me be calm, Nikita. It's okay. You can do it. So I'm really thankful to Shoolini. I'm really thankful to Manju ma'am for everything. So thank you so much, guys.
So actually the pandemic brought everyone together. So we all came together because of the pandemic. And we also read up a lot of texts that we used to like and we did not have time for. So there has been a positive side to the pandemic too. Urmi, are you here? Urmi?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yeah. So thank you so much, ma'am. I'm Urmi Satin from Pandit Deen Dayal Petroleum University. The university is in Gandhinagar. And I'm working there since last 12 years. Ma'am, this conference, I mean, this webinar was very, very important to me because that was the time when we had just started. We did not know anything about pandemic and things were very disturbing and distracting. And at that time, this was the conference which had given us an anchor, and we could anchor our understanding of literature. Very, very, first of all, it was the formal, informal presentation, the oral presentation. But when we came to know, when I came to know that we are going to make it an anthology, we are going to give it a proper structure, it was again going back to the book and going, you know, rereading the paper and rewriting the paper. So I wrote my paper and then I had your comments also. And that is really, really a good, it's a kind of precious thing that I have learned from the conference. And personally speaking, I would like to thank you. At the same time, I would like to compliment you. And the most, something that was very impressive was your way of quoting the literary artist. And the one line which was quoted by you is by Mrs. Dalloway. I'm sorry, it is by Virginia Woolf. And you said, life is not a series of gig lamps symmetrically arranged. It is a luminous halo. It was there in my mind for a longer period of time. And I really felt that this, how true these writers are. I mean, being in the world of literature, it has always been very, very, you know, captivating. And this webinar was also a captivating experience for me, intellectually engaged me. And thank you so very much, ma'am. And I would like to be associated with you in all your future prospects.
At yes, very good, very good. You'll have to make an effort to stay in touch with us. Huh?
Wish you
keep in touch. Yeah.
Very good for your future prospects.
And I must tell you, we are talking about the COVID, we are talking about the pandemic and how it brought us together. And there's another book in the pipeline, which is going to come out in another 2 or 3 weeks, those COVID stories. And the idea of COVID stories came actually in one of the sessions, of the webinar. We were talking about the pandemic, and then I said, there are so many stories. And I said, why don't we put the stories together? And in another 2 or 3 weeks time maximum, we are going to have the stories being brought out like this. Neeraj Datta is helping me with that. So Neeraj, whom you met just now. Shruti, are you here? Shruti?
Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes.
So good afternoon, everyone. I would like to begin with a confession that when the call for this webinar came, I am personally a technologically challenged person. So the fact that we had to look to the screen and into the camera and speak for, you know, a couple of minutes was something that I was thrown back by. We are, you know, usually used to reading papers or making presentations in person in classrooms. But then this webinar made a very important shift, and I think it has become the norm today. And we have somehow learned this art over time. My contribution to this this paper was people who know me know the fact that I am a big fond reader of Virginia Woolf, and my contribution dealt with one of her milestone works, Mrs. Dalloway, and I traced the journey of her critical editions on that work, tracing the, you know, hierarchical journey of how that work has been dealt over the ages. And also I talked about the relevance of that book in the present times. So the most interesting fact about this webinar was that the title itself, going back to the basics, it has been mentioned repeatedly by people that we have forgotten the roots where we come from. We have read these books over times, but then we often forget in this theoretical jargonized world that we live in, what the essential, you know, meaning of that text was, the simplicity of the words with which the author wrote it. So yeah, that was very interesting, and yeah, a driving force for me to join this webinar. And I thank Shoolini University and the entire department for this initiative. Thank you.
Thank you, Vibha. Thank you, Shruti. Is Vibha here? Vibha and Anum. There was a joint presentation from Vibha and Anum. Are they here? Vibha and Anum. Suprabhat, are you here?
Yes, ma'am, I'm here. Am I audible?
Yes, you're audible, but there's a lot of echo. So Suprabhat, I feel like saying good morning to you because your name is Suprabhat. Good to see you here. So let's see.
Good afternoon, ma'am. It's already 12:30, I guess. So it's good afternoon to all of you. Thank you everyone for the opportunity.
There's a lot of echo. There's a lot of echo. So just make it short, please.
Yeah, is it working fine? So I'll just say that what I made in the presentation was more about opening up new windows. I talked about loop, and I talked about Virginia Woolf, talking about feminism. And the window is still haunting me. It's still there in my mind, the new concept of windows and so on. And I'd just like to say that Manju ma'am and the entire Shoolini team, they have given us new windows, or opened up new windows to breathe in this claustrophobic time of pandemic. We're all in there, I mean, in a way, we're all there in our home, we cannot go outside and so on. So thanks to the university, thanks to Manju ma'am. And I think the book, the reading of the book will speak of this as well. So I end up here, and I was from West Bengal, so that was, we were also facing the problem of internet connectivity when we were having
Yeah, so Prabhat, you need to work on your audio. There's a lot of disturbance, yeah? But okay, thank you, thank you. Anoop, are you here? Anoop Sharma? Gopika? I saw Gopika. Yes, Gopika?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, thank you so much, ma'am. Yeah, so I got the book and I'm really excited to see the book in its final form.
Make sure you give it a good rating.
Yeah, definitely. I'm going to do that. So, so thank you all for making this happen. And my contribution here is slightly different because I worked with theory, in fact. And theory isn't, but that's Simone de Beauvoir's The Second Sex. I looked at this chapter, The Narcissist, from this work, but where she's also giving us some practical suggestions, in fact, looking from her times, right? So I looked at this text in the and try to read it in the 21st century YouTubers and the beauty bloggers. So how, when you contextualize this work in this particular context, then what are the things that you can see? How the very concept of beauty blogging actually imbibes some of Beauvoir's positions. At the same time, it contests certain other things. So how things have changed and how, you know, we have moved forward from her times. Okay, so that is what I try to see. But of course, it's nice. It was really lovely to read. I've started reading some of the other essays, so I could read some of the really lovely critical ideas on many of these basic texts. And it was really lovely to see all those things. And thank you once again, Shoolini, Professor Jaidka, and all the editors, the organizers, and the participants and contributors for this. Thank you so
thank
much.
You, Gopika. Thank you, Gopika. And we come to Bhavna Shrey. Bhavna? I saw Bhavna. Come on, Bhavna, quickly.
Hi. Good afternoon, everyone. I hope I'm audible to all.
Yes. Yes, Bhavna.
So because I'm the last person to speak today, I'm obviously at a disadvantage. Everything of worth has been spoken by everyone, and I'm not allowed to thank, so I will not thank. My name is Bhavna Shrey. I am a PhD scholar. Yes, so I will not do so. I'm pursuing my PhD under Dr. Anuradha Ghosh from Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. I'm also an assistant professor under MHRD's TechCube Phase 3 at MITS Gwalior. But my contribution to this entire almost overarching attempt made by Shoolini was that I did something that I have not been able to do in a long while. As we grow up and grow on in literature studies, we sometimes forget that the most important thing are the basics. So this gave me a chance to go back and read what we had read fondly a long time ago, but had not thought about it in a very long time. And also the overarching primary need that is given to look at theory has been taken away. One very extraordinary thing that this entire gratifying academic journey has done is that it has shown us the way to survive. Because for the longest time, I think we thought of Kindles as soulless. I do not think that anymore because of the entire experience that has happened. So Shoolini has shown us that we can exist like this, and it brings me back to Bob Dylan, the times that are changing. And Shoolini has shown us how do they change. So we move from seminar to webinar. We move from hardbacks, from sheep leather bound books to Kindle. And this is how we exist as a liberal arts fraternity together in times that are unprecedented but fascinating at the same time. So thank you so much for the opportunity. I promised I would not say so, but it just came out. Thank you so much. It's been wonderful associating with you all. Thank you.
Well, that's very nice, Bhavna. And if I ask you all to cut down on the thank you, it's because, you know, we can use that time to say so many other things. Huh? We are all here because we are grateful to be here. We are grateful to be together. And meanwhile, my former student Nasser from Iran has been making a lot of, he has been making a lot of signals, but I think he still cannot hear us. But anyway, your presence has been registered, Nasser, and glad you could make it. I have to, before we wind up, there are one or two things that I want to tell you. One, we have the American Literature Conference, Mini Mellow American Literature Conference coming up. And the deadline is just about 1 week away. So come on, all of you, you get cracking and send in your abstracts if you want them to be considered.
I have your voice, ma'am.
Pardon? Nasser. That is Nasser. Hi, Nasser, you're back. Now say Hi. Something quickly, Nasser.
Thank you. Yeah. Yes.
Nasser?
Yeah.
Please introduce yourself.
I'm so happy finally I could join. Do you have my voice, ma'am?
Yes. Yes, we can hear you very well, Nasser.
Good. Great. It is a great pleasure for me to actually just see you, see your friends, that university. It is so amazing. Thank you so much for your efforts. Ma'am, because of you, if we see each other, it is because of you. And I'm so happy about it. I do appreciate your just attempts. Thank you so much for teaching us how to get together, how to talk with each other. Actually, it was a great chance for me to see some people talking about drama, my field of interest, okay? To see you and the other friends talked about, just drama in 20th century. They talked about how drama in 20th century dealt with political issues, okay? How drama in the beginning of 20th century was a kind of campaign of the just workers against the state. How drama was political, delving into who and why human life and existence. It was, just revolutionary, exploring the theme of colonization, okay, and the loss of the territory. They explored about the, different themes actually explored by great dramatists like, Samuel Beckett, Harold Pinter, and the others, okay? So we do know theater, drama in 20th century is amazing field of actually thought, okay? It dealt with human condition. And why it was so great? Because it was something dealing with life. They tried to explore the condition of a human being, political ideologies such as socialism, okay? The rise of depressed women. They tried to give a voice to women, and it was so great, so amazing. They tried to show how industry, although it had some positive feature, but how industry had a negative impact on human life, how industry somehow brought two wars, those catastrophes, how it was created a kind of alienation, okay, to a human being. Because of that, some dramatists try to question the reality, the issue of reality. But finally, at the end of the 20th century, again, dramatists brought the issue of reality because of human condition. Thank you, Dr. Professor Manju Jaidka.
Thank you.
It was
Thank
my
you,
pleasure,
Nasser.
My honor to be with you.
Nasser is, as I told you, he's in Tabriz, Iran. He has done his PhD on post-colonial drama, and he brought out a very fine book. And of course, he was my student too at one time.
Yes.
He and his lovely
family.
It was
a great pleasure and honor for me.
Yeah, they were all stationed in Chandigarh. Okay, so I'm so glad you could join in towards the end. Is there anybody who has not been able to speak? Is Neelima back? Neelima Kanwar? Because in between I saw her, but When I called out her name, she wasn't around. There is also Dr. Praveen Kumar out here. Dr. Praveen Kumar is well known to most of us here, and he also made a presentation in the seminar. But your paper, you did not send your paper, sir. But no, we would like you to share a few words. Yeah.
Good afternoon, everybody. And it was really delightful to be part of the Shoolini University seminar. In fact, this was for the first time I was making a presentation, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. And it was under your leadership that we were able to have a very fulfilling kind of an webinar. My paper was on Orientalism and its relation to the pandemic and how the perception of the East has been undergoing change. This was the topic of my discussion, and I could not contribute my paper. And the reason was I was busy with several other activities which were happening at the same time. So I was making presentation at different places, so I couldn't make a contribution as far as the paper is concerned. But I'm very hopeful that in the next mini Mellow conference that is going to be organized, I'm going to participate, and I'm going to send my abstract very soon. And wonderful. That way I'll be reuniting with you all. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Praveen Kumarji. And is there anybody who would like to say a few words? Anyone here who would like to say something before we have the formal vote of thanks? Ashu, would you like to say something? Yeah, who's that?
Ma'am, that's Monali, ma'am.
Monali, you have already spoken, but okay, you can take 5 seconds more.
Okay, just a word of gratitude again. Of course, I'm not saying thank you, but this is simply because, just because I really wanted to read everybody else's papers and see their abstracts, I got a chance to even compile everybody's abstracts and send it across. I mean, this is how, ma'am, you have been spreading the word of selflessness across in the academic fraternity. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Ashwati, would you like to say something? Dear friend,
I'm pretty much speechless, Manju, after all the people that have spoken. What I was thinking while I was listening to everybody is that within our world, there are so many multiple worlds that exist, right? So thank you for letting me into your world today. Yeah, I am always a very curious.
You're a part of it. Huh?
Yeah, so thank you for making me a part of this today. It is so wonderful. I'm looking forward to downloading the book and reading.
No, and our COVID stories which are coming out, you know, some of them are mind-blowing, really. Huh? So we are very excited about it, waiting for that also.
So just you are very against people thanking you, but I'll say thank you.
I believe that the very fact that we are all here, that means it's a kind of a thanksgiving. So actions speak louder than words, as I say.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Right. So is there anybody else who would like to say one last word? No. May I ask the baby of our family, Sakshi? Ashu, I think you haven't met Sakshi. Sakshi is the new entrant in our department.
Yeah. Hello, ma'am. Yes. Yeah. Not
hello. Sakshi?
Hello, ma'am.
Would you say the formal vote of thanks? And after the formal vote of thanks, what I'll do is I will run the video all over again in case you have missed it, so that we go back with butterflies flying in our mind. Yes, Sakshi.
On behalf of the Department of English, we would like to acknowledge the support of our Shoolini family. Vice Chancellor, Professor P.K. Khosla sir, Pro-Vice Chancellor and Dean, Professor Adil Khosla sir, Avni ma'am, Ashish sir, Ashu ma'am, our trustees Nishtha ma'am and Vishal Anand sir, and to all of our FMSLA friends and colleagues. We are also thankful to all of our friends, students, and other colleagues who are listening in and logged into the session on YouTube and Facebook. A big thank you to you all. Thank you.
Well, that brings us to the end of this scintillating session. I really would call it scintillating session. And before we go, we share the screen once more. Thank you. Well, until next Friday, ciao, ciao. See you again. Bye. Thank you.